What up guys, Cyborg here. We are in Sungai Buloh, close to 66 speed bike, but we're actually at Weli Sungai Buloh to try out the RS660 from Aprilia, the brand new one. Oh, this is a little bit tall. So here we are guys, on board the Aprilia Tuono. This is going to be the V4. I think it's the... Which Tuono is this? Damn! Yeah, it's definitely the 1000cc one. So... alongside me is Panmi Rider, also a YouTuber. Oh, you got the Batman tail lights from the RS660. So we are actually going to be swapping bikes later. Although I mentioned earlier in the video, we are going to be trying out the Aprilia RS660, but I'm on the Tuono. Yeah, I don't have a bit of details on this because I wasn't expecting to be testing out this bike straight up, since it's a naked bike, but it's actually a bit more on the sporty side guys, so I'm actually a bit lean forward, fully digital display. Nice. This one has the Aprilia Akrapovic system and Manaside mirror. Tak payahlah side mirror kan. Yeah, this is the way it's supposed to look guys. But yeah, I mean in the actual world you will have your side mirrors. So this bike is not fully factory, out of the factory. Already got some mods to it. Growl of the V4, memang sedap ah. Awesome sound. Surprisingly, this bike is actually a bit on the tall side. I'm actually on my tiptoes, as you can see. Yeah, so it's actually a bit on the tall side, but still okay. I mean, yeah, if you're a bit more shorter than me, then I think you might have some butt scooting action going on. So let's see. Yeah, you got your gear indicator, the usual stuff, whole bunch of other stuff here, which I have no idea, guys. Honestly, because. There's even a plus button here, I think it's for gear, maybe cruising, yeah. I wasn't prepared for this bike, but we'll just enjoy it as it is. Sometimes you don't need to be like, to know everything. You just want to get on a bike and just enjoy it for what it's worth. So let's belanja bunyi sikit. Nice. Nice growl to it. I believe it's a full system. So definitely guys, you know that it's going to sound like a beast. V4 beast. our tour guide, not tour guide, our guide, or marshal, yeah, marshal, that's the word, is gonna be leading us on the Ducati Scrambler. Yeah, nice brakes, crazy accelerations. Whoa, whoa, nice. So when you're on a test ride, sometimes people just want to get a feel for it, and you know, because I don't know how long this test ride is going to be, the route, so I'm just making the best of it. Straight off, like I said, acceleration is awesome. The slightly lean forward position gives you better control of the bike, since you know, you need to lean forward, you need to get yourself ready for that acceleration when it kicks in, and it kicks in hard. Yeah, just a little bit, and you can feel that, guys. You can even hear it. So as I mentioned earlier, in front of me on the RS660 is gonna be Panmi Rider, also a YouTuber. He does his stuff all in Cantonese. So a different niche, a different audience, I guess. Filtering to traffic, excellent. Yeah, as long as you got enough room. If the space is too tight, then it's not gonna be so fun. So while I'm on the Tuono, enjoying myself, just belanja you guys with some POV action of the RS660. And this RS is also sporting the Akrapovic full system, which later on when we swap bikes, then you can have a listen to it for yourself while we give it some nice revs. What else is on the menu since you're waiting at a traffic light? You got traction control, you got, I think, like track mode setup. Temperature, yeah, for these bikes, definitely temperature is important. In fact, speaking of temperature, I can start to feel the ambient heat radiating out of the engine below my butt. But that's the characteristics of an Aprilia. Definitely it's gonna be a warm and hot experience in your lower regions. The only solution, go fast, bro, go fast. Nice acceleration. Good braking too. If you see I'm riding a little bit like a hooligan, I'm just enjoying this little time I have on the Tuono. It's actually my first time on a Tuono V4. So yeah, just enjoying it. So far the route seems to be pretty decent, and I hope we still get a little bit more seat time. Really cannot open the full throttle of this bike yet. I just can't imagine it. I've managed to open the full throttle of this bike. It's gonna be freaking crazy. Brakes, man, the brakes, really bitey brakes. And he's just chillaxing on his Scrambler Ducati. Styling of the bike, styling is unmistakably Aprilia. You can't confuse this bike for any other bike other than an Aprilia. So it's good. Yeah, the heat is starting to come. I think it's want to do a U-turn, no? Yeah, it's a U-turn. So the route is not that long, but considering the fact that we get to try out the bikes, so I think it's pretty good. So we're going to swap bikes here right now, push it into neutral, put down the stand. And Pan Mi wants to do more setup. No side mirror this time. So we have the Aprilia growling. Stand is up. Waiting for the cars to pass. I see a car passing. Checking everything's good. For new bikes, whenever you're testing bikes, guys, the most dangerous point is doing a U-turn, because you're not familiar with the radius and the way your throttle it kicks in. So that is the most dangerous bit of it when you're doing U-turns. Right, so guys, finally we are on the RS660 for 2021. Brand freaking new bike. Let's talk about riding position. So this bike, compared to my little turtle, the Ninja, how does it fare? I would say this bike actually, the position is not too aggressive. The bars are not too low, surprisingly. Trying to get into neutral, got it. And also we have all these remote control buttons, everything, which again, guys, honestly, I have not researched it. These kind of things, you just need to see the user manual. So I'm not gonna mess around with settings. Just gonna enjoy the bike. Acceleration a bit. Nice torque. And this was the bike that I was on earlier, the V4 1100 Factory. Yeah, I didn't know the exact name. I knew it was a Tono, I knew it was a V4, but I didn't know the actual badge of it. So that's the one in front, is a V4 1100 Factory. So here we are, opening the throttle a bit. Very nice, very strong. Nice throttle feel for it. Like I said, the riding position is, I would say it's actually comfortable for a sport bike. Is this a sport bike class? I believe it is, but it's not too aggressive. The bars are a bit open here, the bars, so my arms are not like a bit cramped in, loosey-goosey. Good feeling to it. The seat is actually quite plush, comfortable seat, quite big and comfortable. Very roomy for my butt. Suspension. Right, suspension is it's a little bit on the softer side. But as you can see, you have adjustments that you can make. Of course, not with my fingers. I'm just pointing it out for you to see. What else we got? What else we got, guys? Fully digital display. Again, it's everything, all the new bikes, this is what they are doing right now. So everything is digital. Styling of the bike is definitely, again, unmistakably an Aprilia styling. That's good. The rear seat, if you guys have seen the clips of the bike, The rear seat, I don't think this bike is designed with a pillion in mind, because the rear seat looks really bad and you have to just get rid of it, put a seat cover. The bike does have a quick shifter, but on lower RPMs, I'm used to pulling in the clutch. Unless we are like full on gassing it, then I'm be using the quick shifter. It's just a habit of mine, because I know quick shifters are not working on low, not they don't work so good on lower RPMs, and you're actually going to hurt your gearbox. So I don't want to do that to this lovely bike. And heat, all right, heat. What do you talk about if on Continental bikes, if not about the heat, right? Definitely you must mention heat. Second gear and highway, but the highway is busy, so let's see. Heat of the bike, like I mentioned, the heat. Yeah, my thighs are feeling it. I think it's bearable for now. Maybe if we are really in some slow traffic and jams or stuff like that. Yeah, letting the quick shifter do some work. Feeling good. For me personally, for this bike, I would say the main thing for me, the main thing I want to point out is that this is a twin. This is not a V2, it's not a V. It's not a V twin, this is just a normal twin. So sound character wise, I'm not super fond of it. Right now you're spotting the full system Akrapovic on this bike as well. So definitely it sounds beasty, throaty, so that's good. But I've yet to hear it on the original sound, the standard sound, which I think is not going to be that interesting, you know. I personally would have thought that if they did a V4, but in a 600 plus capacity, that would be like freaking awesome. But we can't really be choosers about this, right? It depends on the Aprilia guys and why they decided with this setup. So all in all, guys, I think we're just almost at the end of our test ride route. So thumbs up to Wally Sungai Buloh for the test. And thumbs up to the marshal as well. The test route wasn't too bad. Not too long, but also not too short, so I'm okay with it. Luckily, it's not that type of, you know, one circle around the block and done, guys. That's right, kau tim. So let's soak up the bumps. Didn't really get to try out the Rosso Corsas, because, yep, this bike comes ready with Rosso Corsa. So I believe once you get some heat into them, they're gonna stick like glue. U-turn. Adakah U-turn? Really do have a comfortable feeling on this bike. My only wish was the Marshall would go a bit faster so that I can at least, here we got to be careful, I can smell the garbage truck juice, that awesome smelly juice. Nice, finally getting some lean going on. And you can see that juice going on, the juice action. Nah. The right side is a danger, so I'm not gonna chance it, especially on a brand spanking new bike. Yep. Let's go, 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 go. Nice acceleration, man. Nice. Smooth all the way. Woo! Saw that. Excellent. Am I the only one that went? Damn. Where's Panmi? Come on, Panmi. Let me drop a couple of gears. And he wants to record me, I think. So we're just enjoying ourselves. Where's the... where's the test rider? Oh man, after getting lost for fucks, I told you guys I am bad with directions. My sense of direction is shit. I gotta apologize to the welly guys. I am so utterly sorry. Man, what is individual? Alarm ATC disabled. Did I touch something? It's okay, we're almost there, almost there. Lights, change lights. Come on. Alamak. Sorry lah. Sorry. Susat weh.